Hi! In the last episode of Just Pilar, I talked all about the Smurfs and why it was my favorite Saturday morning TV show growing up. When I was a kid, I loved the Smurfs so much that they were all I drew. Day after day, all I drew were Smurfs, 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 Smurfs. They were my favorite thing to draw. And now, years later, I draw my own cartoons, but I still love sketching Smurfs for fun. In this episode of Just Pilar, I'm going to show you how to draw your own Smurf. So come on, let's get Smurfin'! One of the things I love about the Smurfs is their rounded forms. They're just like really fun to draw. And this isn't going to be a perfect tutorial, but it's definitely going to be a tutorial in structure, or we'll attempt to do structure. Even though this is largely in a digital environment, you can do this on paper easily. So all of the principles that I will be talking about in this short tutorial, you could also do with a pencil and pen. So just to keep our character grounded, I drew a floor line. It doesn't have to be perfect, but I drew a floor line. And one of the things about the Smurfs is they're three apples high, but since I don't have that many apples, I'm going to draw with circles and ovals. But one of the things I noticed about the Smurfs is they're about, in the cartoon world, we measure by heads. So the Smurfs are basically like the equivalent of about two heads high. But right now we're going to just assemble with shapes. So one of the things I like to do is I like to start off with an oval. And we're going to just draw like a generic Smurf. And since I like to put the halfway line where the eyes are going to go and the midway line where the nose is anchored. And we're going to do a three-quarter facing to the west view. And, you know, I'm going to just block in the shapes. They have an ear. I love their bodies are just like little, like, lima bean shape, little sandbag-shaped little bodies. And this is a generic male Smurf, so they have his little pants fall like a little more than the line where the pants are fall like a little less than halfway down. His little tail. And now one of the things I like to do is I like to nail the pose. And one of the things I love about the Smurfs is they have like such cute like bendy little legs. I always like to have like one leg more bent than the other. And I'll have like one. One foot kind of turned more towards us than the other. And I'm sort of like just I'm just doing a gestural drawing by doing like sticks for his arms, and like a circle and oval shapes for his fingers. Just really rough right now. And I love how their hands are shaped. So I'm going to draw them like kind of pointing. He's going to be kind of delighted by something. Maybe the Smurfette is visiting him. Now his eyes. The Smurf's eyes are like connected. And even though you don't see the line, like there's not really like a line that goes all the way through to connect it. I like to draw two lines. A line to two ovals. And then when we clean it up later, we're not going to have the line connect all the way in the middle. His nose, they kind of have like a big nose, kind of like a round lima bean shaped nose. And This is going to kind of bring like a little structure to his face because his cheeks kind of come out. And there's a little bit of a taper towards the top. It's kind of, his ear is an oval, but let's give a little bit of structure and show where the inside of his ear goes. And one thing I noticed is that the mouth in a three-quarter view always kind of intersects the nose. And now comes my favorite part, the hat. Like the hat always starts kind of where the ear is. And then there you have like the little fold. Eyebrows always overlap the hat. When I was a kid and I was drawing the Smurfs, like the hat was always like the hardest part. But the hat just kind of wraps around his head. It starts with the ear and kind of follows the contour of the very kind of top of his head. And same with the little fold. And then the back of the hat kind of wraps around into like this little flap thing and comes down. Let's start fleshing out the legs a little bit. Start fleshing out the arms. So then we have our rough sketch laid in. And now we're going to start to sort of see all my little search lines and everything. Those don't have to stay there. Actually, if this were on paper, I would encourage you to take a kneaded eraser and go over your pencil line a little bit. But in this digital environment, I just made the line lighter, and then now I'm going to go over it with a pen. And first thing I do is eyebrows overlapping his hat. And his eyes are kind of oval shaped. And his pupils, black. There's not really any like eye color to Smurfs, even though in the new movies, the movies show the Smurfs have blue eyes. Oops, I messed that up. There. Thought I had to erase the inside of his ear because I had it backwards. You know, and it's not perfect, but I'm going over each line, each search line. His ears. His head kind of overlaps. His body, there's kind of like a line. What's really cool, if this were Hefty Smurf, his shoulders would be more pronounced. Matter of fact, I think I'm going to go ahead and make it Hefty Smurf. So his shoulder would actually overlap his head to just show he's Hefty Smurf. Let's make him look tough then. Give him like more pronounced eyebrows. See, and I'm just kind of going over and like bringing out my lines. And sometimes when you clean up, like you might even like do a little correction as you go along. Because notice how I'm bringing in the end of his hat. Because I kind of feel like it needs to go in more. And the Smurfs, in true cartoon style, only have 3 fingers and a thumb on each hand. And sometimes I like to do like a little shadow. Actually, where the leg overlaps, there is a shadow. There would be a shadow. Even like where the inside of the ear. And we can't forget, Hetty's tattoo, which I believe is a heart. Try that again. Because Hefty, even though he's tough, he's a lover, not a fighter. And then, if you want it to, just for illustration's sake, you can, if you're working in a digital environment, you can get rid of your pencil line in the background. And there we have it. Hefty Smurf. I hope you enjoyed my tutorial on how to draw a Smurf. Smurfs are so cute and so fun to draw. So thanks for joining us, and see you next time on Just Pilar.